Hey everybody, it's episode 5 of NEGU TV, and I just want to tell you first and foremost, we love you guys. Thank you so much for your support. As I hit the rewind button and think of September and National Childhood Cancer Awareness Month, you guys showed up so big and your support was so amazing. So first and foremost, thank you so much. I'm wearing the gold shirt one more time, then it's going to go in the closet for a year. But we're again just so thankful for your support. And as we get ready to kick off October, we had the opportunity to bring in some special guests from the Anaheim Ducks. Yes, hockey fans, I wish I could be like the announcer going now starting. But Rickard Rakell and Wendy Asaro from the Anaheim Ducks, we're so excited you guys to be here. Thank you. So Rickard, when did you start playing hockey?
I was really young. I was probably about 4 or 5 years old. Went to practice with my brother, and my dad asked if I can go on the ice with them. And that's how it began.
Yeah. And so is your brother older or younger?
He's 2 years older.
Man. 2 years older. So, does he also play hockey?
Yeah. He still plays back home in Sweden. So it was my brother and my cousin. They were on the same team. So I jumped crazy in there.
That's awesome. So what is like one of the favorite things that you enjoy about playing at the Honda Center in front of the Ducks fans?
I mean, playoffs is pretty tough to beat. It's loud, and when everybody's wearing the orange t-shirts in the stand, it's pretty amazing feeling.
So obviously, I've never been a professional player of any sport. So when I always thought, so like when you guys are down there and you're actually trying to focus on the plays and hear things from the bench, you can hear the crowd?
Yeah, sometimes.
Yeah. Okay.
Depends. Like if you're in the penalty box and someone's right on the glass yelling something at you, you hear what they say. But when you're in the game, it's you don't really focus on what's going on around you.
So you said something about the penalty box. Have you ever been in there?
Not very often, but
good job,
it happens. It happens.
Well, we obviously love the Anaheim Ducks. And Wendy, you guys have graciously picking the Jessie Reese Foundation to be part of the National Hockey League's campaign of Hockey Fights Cancer. Tell me a little bit more about that. Tell the viewers about what is that.
So Hockey Fights Cancer is an annual campaign that happens throughout the National Hockey League. And every year we dedicate one game night for fans to be able to kind of participate in that initiative and really build awareness and fundraising, for those who are fighting cancer, trying to honor that, as well as, you know, certain organizations that are doing great things in our community. So for the second year, we're so excited that
you guys are on board
with us. We know it's a lot of work for you, but we're so appreciative and doing whatever we can. The fans are always so great, to get involved. And, you know, last year brought socks, and we're going to have them do that again this
year
for the JoyJars, and just to be able to spread more awareness about all the great work that your organization does, as well as, you know, hopefully being able to fundraise and give fans the opportunity to be able to be a part of something that the NHL, you know, does, throughout the whole month, campaign. So yeah, we're really excited to have you guys on board again.
Well, thank you so much. I'm super stoked to even, you know, be in this little studio with you guys, because the Anaheim Ducks mean so much to us being Orange County based and stuff. And Rakell, you know that we focus on helping children fighting cancer, never ever give up. It was my daughter's little motto, NEGU, never ever give up, while Jessie was fighting cancer. And so we know of a local girl, her name's Katie, that was fighting cancer, and she's actually fought in cancer for over 9 years. She beat it and came back, and then recently came back for a third time. And I just want to thank you as Jessie's dad for taking time in Sweden with your dog Stella sitting on a couch recording a message for this little girl, because it made a humongous difference in her life. We like to say at the Jessie Reese Foundation, we don't cure cancer, we cure bad days. And Katie was having a bad day, and you took 30 seconds of your life and has brought in her years and years of excitement just because of her reaction when she saw it. So I want to ask you if you would help me do another surprise for Katie.
Absolutely.
Oh, this is so awesome. So Katie actually is over in the JoyFactory. making Joy Jars, because we're trying to kind of capture her whole story, because it's pretty courageous. 9 years of going back and forth and, you know, going and, you know, being a girl and losing your hair and all the things that that means. And she keeps fighting and keeps fighting and keeps fighting. And so what I'd like for you to do, and Wendy, obviously you can come with us, is just get up right now and head over there and just surprise her. And I think she'll probably want to teach you how to make a Joy Jar or something. But this is all about just making her smile. And I would appreciate if you would do that for me. Would you help me?
Of course. Let's go.
Okay, let's do this, man. All right, guys. NEGU TV, we love you guys. We're off to make a girl smile bigger than ever. Yeah! See ya!
So there are some things. Hi, Katie.
Oh, wait, what? Oh my god, why? Wait, what?
I was hoping you would show me how to make some jar.
Will you show me?
Okay, so... you,
Oh, that's
you
great.
Want the faces?
Yeah, I
see that. Out the front. Hey!
Surprise!
I'm very surprised. Oh my gosh!
I'm super excited to be here.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh! Thank you so much for coming.
Of course. I mean, it's my pleasure. All
right.
I'm just gonna do what you do.
Okay. So I usually put the heavy stuff. I've stuffed dreads before. I usually put the heavy stuff at the bottom.
Yeah.
I don't know. I just find that easier. There you go.
Is this a good one or is it?
Yeah,
great?
I think that's good. Yeah.
All right. We'll do it like that. Perfect. Ooh.
Well, we're back. Oh my gosh, that was like over the top incredible. I wish you could see the entire thing, but I know you just got done watching some of it, and it was amazing. And I am just so, again, thankful, Rickard, for coming here and taking time out. And thank the Anaheim Ducks for all you guys do for kids fighting cancer. We love you guys. But today you helped us, you know, bring a smile to a beautiful girl. So first and foremost, thank you. So Katie, what was it like to first see Rickard turn the corner and now you're, you know, teaching him how to make a Joy Jar?
It was very surprising and nerve-wracking.
Yeah.
You're one of my idols, especially for hockey, since you kind of got me back into hockey. I kind of took a break of it and you're what kind of got me back into it, and so that was super exciting.
That's awesome. So he doesn't have a jersey on, so what number is he?
He's number 67.
67. So Ducks fans, make sure you're cheering for 67. That's awesome. Katie, you are an inspiration to us. You have fought cancer so courageously. So tell me a little bit, tell the viewers that are watching, if they could just peek a little bit into your story about childhood cancer, what would you like to share?
I started off very normal. My life was just like any other kid, going to school, playing soccer on the weekends and during the week, since my dad. And just out of the blue, I got a stomach ache, and I still remember the weekend exactly. I just wasn't feeling good, and I still had to play the game, and so I fought through it. And I think that's kind of the first thing that I had to do, was just fight through that game.
Yeah.
The fight through that game was just like the fight through the next few years that I was about to endure with this cancer. And so we went to the doctor, and the doctor felt something in my stomach. She's like, that's not normal. You have something in your stomach. You've got to get it out. Got into the hospital within a few days, which is extremely rare.
Wow,
sometimes
yeah.
It takes weeks or even months for kids to get treated.
Right.
And they told my parents that I got diagnosed with cancer at the age of 9.
Wow.
I don't remember the day my dad told me, which is really weird because I remember everything after. Hmm. I remember that they asked my dad, do you want us to tell her that she has cancer? And he goes, absolutely not. I will be the one to tell her. Okay, according to my dad, I asked him, am I going to die? Obviously, I had no idea what cancer was, and I don't even think my parents really knew what it was.
Yeah.
So I've been fighting ever since that. It's been 8 years now.
Wow.
Keep going into remission, and then it just keeps coming back, because this type of cancer just hides inside the bones.
Mm.
So you can't really see it, even though it says that there's nothing on the scan.
So just for the viewers, my understanding is that you beat it once.
Yes.
You beat it twice.
Yes.
And recently it snuck back.
Yes.
So you're right now back into fight mode.
Exactly. But I wasn't at first. And that's what NEGU is kind of here for. And they helped me. When I got it the third time, I told my parents that I was done.
Mm.
I didn't want to fight anymore.
I'm sorry.
I knew that I was going to go through all the pain and the suffering. And I didn't want to do it.
Yeah.
I'd rather be with Jesus and Jessie in heaven, celebrating and partying, than being here and be in pain.
I'm so sorry.
But NEGU was really just there for me, and like they give me stuff like this, and stuff like this is what makes me want to keep fighting. It makes me like keep looking forward to having things planned in my life.
Well, thank you for what you just shared. That takes so much courage and so much bravery. So again, thank you for that. Like I said earlier, you are an inspiration to us. Obviously, I miss my daughter every day, but to know what we get to do and to see that we're helping you fight is just so important to us, because that's what this is all about. You got to have hope every day. And Jessie's little motto, to never ever give up, was a message just crammed about hope and strength, and you are just the picture of that. And you, I just want you to know that you're never alone, okay? Even though some days you might feel alone, this foundation stands with families to make sure they're never, ever alone. And not only do we stand with you, the Ducks stand with you. Your message and your story has inspired Rakell and the entire Anaheim Ducks community. And so Rickard has something to offer you.
Yeah, we do have a surprise for you, because your story is so inspiring, and everything you do for other kids and the foundation. So we want you to be with our team for opening night at Honda Center and being introduced as our 21st duck.
Oh yeah!
Oh my gosh, that's so cool.
Do you know how to skate?
What?
Do you know how to ice skate?
No.
Okay.
Then you gotta come down to practice on Tuesday and being with the team, and you get your own locker and just being around us.
Seriously, you're the 21st player that night. You get to participate the entire evening as the 21st duck.
Oh my gosh, that's so funny. That's so fun. I've always wanted to go out on the ice and help you guys out, score.
Well, Rickard, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. And again, thanks to Anaheim Ducks. You guys rock. We love you guys. And Katie, thank you for your continued decision to fight, because that can sometimes can be a hard decision. I'm sure Rickard has had injuries in life that he's had to try to go, gosh, do I have to come back from this thing again? And that injury has nothing to compare to what you go through. But your never, ever give up spirit inspires us, inspires these viewers to keep going. And so we love you, and we thank you so much. And so whenever we end an episode of NEGU TV, we say, we NEGU do you. Can you do that with me?
Yeah.
Okay, one, two, three.
We NEGU do you.
See you guys. Love you.